Greetings, friends, Sonic Toast, and welcome to our very first Martial Arts Monday featuring Street Fighter figures from Jada Toys. Now, if you see in the previous video I did, we unboxed the Ryu figure and we reviewed him, and I just thought this figure was amazing. I think Jada did such a great job with their Ryu. And I believe I said that I would definitely get Ken because, you know, for my Smash Brothers figure collection, I need Ryu and need Ken. And so, sure enough, when they made Ken, I had to get him. But honestly, when these other characters came out, I felt like I just needed all these other characters too. And also, you may remember we did compare Ryu to the Playmates Ryu that came in the Ninja Turtle crossover packs. And the Jada one is just so significantly better. This was a valiant effort on the part of Playmates, but no, Jada just hit it out of the park, making the Playmates figure pretty obsolete. Similarly, we also previously reviewed the Chun-Li figure that came in the Ninja Turtle crossover packs. And I don't think this Chun-Li was as bad as Ryu. I think it was a pretty valiant effort also, not a bad figure. And so that is why, instead of getting the regular Chun-Li from Jada, I decided to go with the variant red Chun-Li for, you know, like the player 2 colors. And so we'll go ahead and compare that to the Playmates Chun-Li, and we're going to get all these guys open. We have, like I said, the player 2 Chun-Li, we have Dalsum, we have M. Bison, and we have Ken. So we're going to review all those figures today. Oh boy, toast! Alrighty, we got them open, and first thing to notice is that each character comes with a little background, like a little diorama of the stage, their main stage from the game Street Fighter 2. So that is pretty cool. Got China, India, you know, all those places. Now let's get into the accessories. Each character comes with an alternate head, like a more intense head that looks like, you know, they're in the middle of battle, and they each come with two alternate hands, usually like a half open, you know, with their fingers clenched. Well, at least in the case of Dalsum, M. Bison, and Ken, Chun-Li comes with like these flat open karate chop hands. We can see their default heads are like more neutral, relaxed, and their default fists are just clenched, you know, closed fists. Except Dalsum, he has open hands, but yeah, he has the neutral face. Same with Chun-Li, and she has the closed fists also. Now let's get into the unique accessories, starting with Dalsum, as Dalsum comes with his appendages, but all stretched out and long, as he has that ability to stretch out his arms and legs. And then he comes with this here stand, which I think is used to support his stretched out arms and legs so he does not fall down. So here he is. Oh, he fell down. So here he is doing a yoga kick, and I put the alternate leg on him. I had to put a NECA stand on his foot to get him to balance, and unfortunately the holes in their feet are not compatible with NECA stands, so it's kind of loose. It'll fall right out pretty easily on there, but oh well. And here is how he looks with all his arms and legs completely stretched out. Yep, I'd probably be making that face too. One thing to note is that the stretched out limbs do not have any articulation. They are kind of rubbery, and you cannot switch out these hands with his other alternate hands. So that's Dalsum. Let's move on to the guy who started this all, at least for me, and that's Ken, right? And boy, this figure has such amazing articulation. I think they all do, actually, because they have that, like, that chest bend, and then they have the shoulder, they have the bicep, the bending elbows, the bending wrists, the twisting wrists, they have the abdominal crunch, the twist at the waist, the head and neck articulation, they have the twist at the thigh, the moving leg, the double jointed knees, the bending feet, the twisting ankle, like the pivot at the foot, like everything you could want in an action figure, these guys have, and it is incredible. Anyway, so Ken comes with this. It's like a Hadouken, which comes on the little stand there. There, so there's Ken with his alternate head and alternate hands shooting his Hadouken. I think my only criticism for Ken is that I kind of wish he came with a head that has a closed mouth. See, this one has his angry one showing his teeth. This is his happy one showing his teeth. I kind of wish we had a closed mouth where he's doing his cocky smirk, you know, the way that he does. Now, another thing about Ken is, just like Ryu, you can remove his belt and remove his gi completely and have him be shirtless. So that's pretty cool. I'm not going to do it right now because I don't feel like it. And yes, Ryu's head does fit on Ken. So if you want Ryu in a red gi, that is an option. And vice versa. I actually think Ken looks really good in white.
And I just have to reiterate that if these figures were not such high quality at such a reasonable price, I would have quit at just Ryu and Ken. I would not have gotten all these other characters. But because Jada just hit it out of the park with making such good figures, I felt like it's very justified to support Jada in getting these cool figures and adding to my own, you know, collection of video game characters with all of these iconic Street Fighter combatants. Like, it is really great, a great time to be a figure collector, a great time to be a video game fan, and a great time to be a fan of Street Fighter.
Now, Dhalsim did not come with his Yoga Fire, but I kind of feel like we could maybe recycle Ken's Hadouken. Yoga Fire! Yoga Flame! Hey, wait a second, I just noticed, look! Ken's hands are inside of there. What? That is some real detail right there. Holy cranberries. That made me pull out my Ryu accessories from the last time we reviewed the Ryu figure, and look, Ryu's hands are inside there too. What in the world? I never noticed that before.
All right, so that's Dhalsim and Ken. Let's move on to Chun-Li. Now, Chun-Li, like I said, got her in her red outfit. And before we get into the aspects of this figure, I want to compare her to the Playmates one in the blue outfit. Yes, Jada did make her in the blue outfit also, but I thought maybe since I had one in the blue outfit, I'd go with the red one this time. And yeah, we can just see these are very, very different figures. The Playmates one is a bit taller, and the articulation seems to be pretty on point for both. However, I do think Jada might have more going on.
Because let's see here, Playmates has what you would expect with the shoulder articulation. It has the bicep, it has double jointed elbows, it has bending wrists that also twist, right? So that's the arms. Now in comparison, let's look at Jada. Jada also has a very similar shoulder. The twist of the bicep is also there, except it's on the arm itself, which is inside of the sleeve, which is clever. Instead of what Playmates did was have the whole sleeve rotate, but this makes the sleeve seem more like clothing, right? We have the double jointed elbows on her also, and then the bending, twisting wrists. So in terms of arms, they are the same. Let's go back to Playmates now. Head articulation, we have the ball joint head, as would be expected. In terms of the body, she twists at the waist, no abdominal crunch, right? Let's take a look at what Jada has. Jada has the ball joint head also, but she also has a joint at the neck itself, where the neck meets the body. So that is a little bit more head movement there. She also has the twist at the waist, and she has the abdominal crunch, so she can move, you know, do sit-ups and stuff like that. Now for the legs, let's go to Playmates. As Playmates has the expected leg articulation and the twist at the thigh. She has the double jointed knee bend. And then she has her foot that can articulate up and down. She can pivot at the ankle. And there's not a designated twist. You can just sort of move the foot around. Okay, so that is Playmates. Now let's take a look at Jada. Jada also has the expected leg articulation with a twist at the thigh, a bend at the knee, and then she actually has a twist at the boot here that Playmates did not have. And then she has the bending, pivoting foot also. Actually, there's not much of a pivot at the ankle, really. It just sort of bends up and down. That's about it. So yeah, honestly, there is not a ton of extra articulation on the Jada one compared to the Playmates one. I think the biggest thing is just having the crunch here, being able to move her up and down like that, while Playmates does not do that. So that is the main thing. In terms of sculpt, yeah, the Jada sculpt is definitely significantly better. We have texture on her clothes, and just overall a better paint job, better quality. Now Chun-Li can put her leg up like so and her toe out so that you can put her kick attack on her like that. Yeah, 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 yeah. All right, and then she comes with a stand to support the kick attack, and she actually balances pretty well, unlike Dhalsim, so that is kind of cool.
All right, last and definitely not least, the big boss man himself, M. Bison. You're not going turbo, are you? All right, so first thing to notice on M. Bison is his cape is just magnificent. Look at it. You can like bend it in different directions every which way. This is just an incredible cape. What quality. Just like the others, he has texture on his clothes. He has all that same articulation, like the bend and the twist and everything. Boy, and then look how his armored boots and wrists look are all shiny. This is such a cool figure. Boy, I wish M. Bison were in Smash Brothers just so I can display this guy on my Smash Brothers shelf. He looks fantastic. Now, out of these four figures, M. Bison is the only one who did not come with a support stand for any kind of attack. Instead, he came with his, like, fire fist or whatever you call it. So you put that right there, and he can punch you with it. And then the only other accessories he has, aside from his alternate head and alternate hands, is his, well, he has this amazing cape. But the cape does come off. And with that, you need to take off the entire shoulder pads here. So let's go ahead and see if we can do that. The shoulder pads are supposed to, I think. Oh, there we go. So it just clips. It's like a shoulder clip. You just gently lift it from the back and those come off. So then you can fight. Of course, that looks a little funny. So it comes with the alternate shoulder pads here. So it looks like what you do is you put it on the front. And then you push down on the back and it just sort of clicks right in. Wow, he's even got shoulder pad articulation. These move up and down. He can use his arms to their fullest also. Crazy. I mean, the cape accessory is so amazing. It's kind of a shame not to use it, but really he does fight without the cape most of the time. So it is really cool that they do give you this option to not have the cape on him. So friends, this brings us to the conclusion of the video in terms of sculpt, proportions, accessories, articulation. This set of Street Fighter figures is like the best of the best. One of the best collections of figures I have seen in a very long time. I cannot get over just the extreme quality of these figures. They are so, so good. And I don't mean to blubber all over them, but I am just being sincere here. I am not a huge Street Fighter fan, but I am a huge fan of these action figures. They are just fantastic, right? Do I have some criticisms? Of course, I always have criticisms. One thing, I wish they came with stands for their feet to help them stay standing, especially Dalsum. Or if they don't come with stands, at least make the holes in their feet compatible with the stands that NECA sells, because that would be better than nothing, right? Aside from that, these are fantastic. I highly recommend them to anybody who is at least a little bit interested. I guarantee you will be satisfied. At a very fair price of $20 to $25, it is really not bad. I don't see myself collecting every single one. I'm definitely getting Zangief because I have to reenact the Patanon meeting from Wreck-It Ralph. Besides that, I just want to get like my favorite ones, like E. Honda and Blanca, probably just the whole original eight and the bosses. And then maybe some of the other ones from that came after that, maybe like Akuma or, you know, whoever else. I don't know, we'll see. But yeah, I don't plan on getting every single figure, and of course not in every single color. But yeah, these are really great figures. And as a bonus, because you know I do love Ninja Turtles, April O'Neil's head does fit on Chun-Li, and she looks pretty good. And that means that Chun-Li's head also fits on April's body, which is kind of perfect, because if I remember correctly, the old 90s Street Fighter movie, when Chun-Li was played by Ming-Na Wen, she was actually a news reporter. So friends, thank you so much for watching this Martial Arts Monday with these Street Fighter figures from Jada Toys. Let me know what you think about these down in the comments section. If you ask me, you know, we got the Count Chocula cereal figures, we got the Chester Cheetah figure, we have these Street Fighter figures. Like, Jada can do no wrong right now, in my opinion. I have the Mega Man figures on order, so we'll have to do a Mega Man Monday as soon as those come, and we'll see how Jada did there. But until then, thank you so much for watching, friends. Please subscribe and toast. No boy. Let's see. We got to put Ryu back on the guest star Smash Brothers shelf here. Right here next to Kazuya before. Now we gotta find a spot for Ken. Let's see. Sorry. Sonic, let's move you for just a second. Promise you'll be back. And What if we put Ken here, next to Ryu, in front of Simon Belmont, with fist out, all like, yeah! And then we'll just put Sonic back right there in front of Ken. There we go. Very cool. Very cool. And sorry, Mega Man. You might be getting replaced soon. Don't get too comfortable. We'll see Funko versus Jada. We will see on Mega Man Monday coming, I'm not sure when, probably later this month sometime. Toast!